Welcome to this second part describing my home-brewed automatic powder dispenser. In this episode, we will disassemble BSIRAD. The lid has a built-in two-dimension spirit level, so you can assure that BSIRAD is properly leveled. The lid to the scale compartment is just to lift off. The floor to the accessory space is just to pull up. The interface panel is also just to lift off. By disconnecting the DuPont connectors, the panel is completely loose. There are openings between the different compartments to let cables through. I disconnect the web camera and the power supply for the illumination and push the cables back through the passage. Then I remove the scale with the web camera. I also remove the illumination unit. In the bottom of the scale compartment, there is a loose floor. It keeps the scale in its position without interfering with it. The power cords to the stepper motor is connected via screw terminals, as I did not have any suitable connectors at hand at the time of build. It is meant to be upgraded with some sort of quick coupling in the future. And there we are. Just lift up the power feeder. The electronic unit could be lifted up and then easily be separated. All for easy maintenance. Not that BSIRAD really needs any maintenance. We end up with an empty encapsulation, mainly built from offcuts and other waste. You can see the adjustable feet at the bottom. I nicked those from discarded office furniture. Let's take a quick look at the different parts. There is a USB hub, not necessary during normal operation. I use it during development when I need to connect keyboard, mouse and monitor. There is my homemade LED illumination. Do not repeat my mistake and build one. It is not worth the hassle. You can get one on eBay for less than a dollar. BSIRAD is driven by a Lenovo laptop power supply. This one provides 20 volts and 3.2 ampere. Almost any laptop power adapter would work. BSIRAD accepts anything between 15 and 48 volts. Then we have the interface panel. It consists of a standard LCD 20 characters by 4 rows, and home-soldered PCB and momentary push buttons, all wired to a DuPont connector that fits to the Raspberry Pi's GPIO pins. There are also wired connectors that goes to the stepper motor driver board. The electronics starts off with a power socket, which feed a 5-volt transformer and a 12-volt transformer. The 5-volt is fed to a USB hub, and the 12-volt is fed to the stepper motor driver board. The Raspberry Pi Zero is connected to the USB power hub. The powder feeder consists of a 12-volt bipolar stepper motor, a carrier console, and a powder hopper. The hopper is made from a plastic jar and a section from an FM radio antenna. The carrier console is equipped with a boosting heel to give the feeder a small angle. The RCBS M500 scale has been slightly modified. All changes are 100% reversible. I have attached a console to hold the background and a web camera. The scale tags has been painted white to increase contrasts. The scale tag surroundings has been covered with a black marker for the same reason. I have connected the components without the main encapsulation to demonstrate operations. The only components missing is the illumination. It is not necessary outside the box. The software will calibrate according to the prevailing light conditions. I'm loading 9.00 grains of Vichtavori tinstar. ...24 seconds and no deviation. Let's try another one. As you notice, the throws are both fast and extremely accurate. There are no commercial products that measure up to the standards of BSIRAD. Another 24 seconds and no deviation. This was all for now. In the upcoming episodes, we will go through all components used. See where you can get them and how much they cost.